Welcome back, guys. One of the biggest complaints owners have is when their sales associates or project managers go out to job sites and forget to properly spec out the roof and the property to write that estimate later on. This problem can be solved by using a simple property spec sheet, which, by the way, you can download in your virtual file vault. If you don't haven't already done so, go ahead and press pause and download this from your virtual file vault. Hey guys, you can access important documents like this right from your SVG U virtual file vault. You can access the SVG U virtual file vault right from your main menu or homepage in your Lightspeed account. Simply look for the SVG U matching course inside the file vault and look for the document you need. Click on that document and you can download it in real time and access it right from your iPhone or iPad, or print them out the office when you go meet those property owners and insurance adjusters. Now, I know a lot of you guys are using Eagle Views and iRoofing to measure your roof. Those satellite images don't get the ventilation systems. They don't get the plumbing stacks and all that stuff. All that stuff has to be spec'd out in order to write a proper estimate. They also don't get the other exterior areas around a house that are damaged by the hail, the windstorm, and whatnot. So guys, looking at our property spec sheet, pretty simple. What type of storm was it? Hail, hurricane, wind? What type of roofing system on top here? It's real important to be sure to include photos of all areas of damage that you note on the property, okay? So over each elevation. So if you notice here on your exterior, on your left column, you have front, right, rear, left. Just like the adjuster walks around the property, he's gonna write it by elevation. How many window screens were damaged? How many windows were damaged by elevation? How many gutters? How many downspouts, fascia? You know, all that exterior stuff, AC units. And this will quickly tell whoever's writing the estimate later on how to properly write the estimate. Okay, you also got your roof specs, your steep charges. I know Eagle View is picking some of that stuff up, but it's not gonna get the details, okay? And sometimes Eagle Views are wrong. We got our drip edge. What kind of drip edge is it? Is it copper? The house we're gonna go on today, you're gonna see it's copper drip edge. If you didn't write that down and they wrote it for regular drip edge, you could lose up to $28 a linear foot. So these are very important things while you're scoping out the house. What type of valley? Is it closed? Is it W's? Is it copper valleys? You can't see that from a satellite. So again, guys, just take a few minutes when you're on that roof inspection and check the boxes. You don't have to be an estimate writer to do this, but you need to check the right boxes so whoever's writing that estimate later on at the office can write a proper estimate. Another big area here, guys, is roof accessories. Power vents, furnace stacks, 4 foot off ridge vents, furnace caps, whirlybirds, skylights, all this kind of stuff is difficult to see on that satellite image report. And if you don't mark them down, not only can you not estimate or supplement for those items, but your production manager later on is gonna order the wrong vent systems, and it's gonna cause a trip charge and a roofer to stop production and someone to go back out to that job site several times, which is a real pain in the ass. So we're quickly writing down our roof specs. Do we have a TV antenna? Do we have solar panels up there? And again, we're just doing a scope, guys, so we can write that estimate properly back at the office. It's also helpful. I know a lot of you guys don't draw roofs or measure them anymore, but if you notice something weird on a property, use that quick takeoff sheet. If the house needs an emergency repair, if it needs a tarp, write a quick area where that leak's coming in so that the folks back at the office can send that order out to the roofer to tarp the right area, so it's not a guessing game later on. Same with any kind of special vents, skylights, anything odd in that property you should always take a picture of and jot some notes on your takeoff sheet. Last, guys, there's an interior section here so that we can work through the inside of that property by room and mark down where we have paint and drywall damage. Okay, guys, this last section here, additional components, items, or notes, that's for anything else that's not on this piece of paper that you need to write about this property. For example, when we do the walk around this property today, we're gonna have things like hot tub covers, solar powered copper lanterns outside, electrical issues with the outdoor lighting. That's a great area to write those things down so we can estimate them later on. See you soon.
Wake up, guys. You gotta get 100% on those questions after this test in order to proceed to the next chapter. See you soon.